Namaskar. Welcome to this edition of Holistic Healing. Today we will talk about alcohol or drinking. There was a time when it was treated to be a social stigma if you drank. But today, social drinking has become the norm, it has become practice. And not only has it been given some kind of social acceptance, some people even believe that alcohol has some positive effects on you. Let's discuss this in great detail. Our habit is that whatever is to our liking, we twist those things in our favor. Let's clarify this myth about advantages of drinking in the very beginning. The very first thing you to understand is that if at all there is any kind of benefit, it comes only and only from red wine. You cannot extend that to every kind of drink. Even in red wine, this red wine benefits only those who are regular eaters of red meat. It will help in negating the ill effects of red meat. Otherwise, if you are a normal, either a vegetarian or you are eating other kinds of meat, there is no research which says that red wine is any good for you. Secondly, the so-called benefits of red wine come from a chemical called resveratrol, which in any case is present in great quantity in grapes and grape juice. So if you don't drink, you don't have to start drinking to get any benefits. You can get all those positive effects from your simple glass of grape juice. Still, if you are going for red wine, at what clip you drink it is very important. You have to nurse your drink for hours altogether. In fact, that is the main secret behind the so-called French paradox. People say that French people drink regularly, but see, they've got good health. The secret is that they will take that glass of wine over 2 hours. Slowly they will drink it, sip by sip. That is how every drink should be taken, but our tragedy is that we take even much harder drinks and we take them very quickly. So the first thing you have to get out of your mind is that there's any reason to drink. There's no reason. It will harm you come what may. Now the question is, if at all you have to drink, how to minimize the damage? Every drop of alcohol is going to create problems. Be very certain about that. You will know about it, but a little too late. I'm sure you know many people who have ruined their health by drinking, but you will not find anybody who got a bad liver after 1 day or 1 week or 1 month of drinking. Our body is so sturdy. It is made of such good material that it can withstand even alcohol for years altogether. It is bound to damage. Some say that I know how to hold my drink. They're very convinced that, especially in my part of the country, one phrase very regularly used is, alcohol runs in my veins. I wish it could be true. It doesn't happen like that. You should understand what is happening. You see, every country has an army whose job it is to protect the country from all enemies. In our case, this army is our immune system. It keeps a constant vigil on what comes into the body. You can take this immune system as a watchdog. Nobody comes into your house till it has confronted your dog. Now, supposing your dog is on guard duty at night, a thief comes and you catch hold of him, pat your dog. The dog feels thrilled. After all, it has the mind of a young child. So it will be very vigilant the next time also. Supposing you do exactly the opposite. Supposing a thief comes to your house, your dog barks. Instead of shooing away the thief, you give a beating to your dog. Why did you spoil my sleep? What will happen is that the next time your dog will be scared of barking. It will not bark with the same vigor and power. Suppose you do the same mistake time and again, 10 times, 20 times, 30 times. One day the dog will get the message that, look, it is absolutely wrong to be creating a ruckus. I should sleep properly. It will not even bark. Exactly the same thing happens when you start drinking. As you must have experienced, we take our first drink at the age of 16, 17, 18. Normally, when you are clearing your high school examination, after that, your friends start asking you to take that sip of beer or whatever. At that time, our immune system is very strong. So it violently protests. You puke, you have this giddiness, your body doesn't like it one bit. Unfortunately, your friends taunt you by saying that you are a kid, you cannot hold your drink. As you all know, at that age, nobody wants to hear these words. They take it as some kind of a personal insult. So it becomes a challenge that come what may, I'll teach myself how to drink. So you drink again the next day. This time the reaction is slightly less, but there is reaction nevertheless. Third time also there is reaction. 4, 5, 6 times, and then there are people who are every time going to keep on provoking you. Incidentally, have you noticed that nobody encourages you to do a good task so strongly? But when it comes to drinking or smoking, your friends are always there to help you. So they'll keep on saying, you try it, sooner or later it'll go up. And all that is happening is that your dog is getting weaker and weaker. One day what will happen is it will stop barking. And your friends will now compliment you. My boy, finally you have grown up. You have learned how to hold your drink. Nothing could be farther from truth. You have killed your immune system good and proper. Now what will happen is that this poison will go into your body, it will be all pushed into your liver, and it will start damaging your liver without you even coming to know about it. It will be like termite in the wood. Your liver is a very strong part. You will be surprised that liver is directly responsible for taking care of more than 500 functions in your body. Because of the strength, it can even withstand the attack of alcohol. 1%, 2% damage will come in. You will have no pain, no nothing. And not even medical reports will tell you that something is going wrong. The first sign would come only after you have damaged it to say 20%, 25%. Unfortunately, even when your doctor advises that you have to go off alcohol, we don't take it very seriously. Why? Because one, by then we are addicted, and two, we have friends who are always going to say that, forget about doctors, they say so many things, you must take a little bit of that. We'll continue. At times, the damage goes so far that cirrhosis of liver takes place, by then it is too late. So we must be very careful about what we are doing. Totally remove this idea from your mind that you are doing good to yourself. You are basically killing yourself. It may be slow poison, but it is poison nevertheless. Now the important factor for us is that if at all we are taking it, how to minimize the damage? The trick involved is, first of all, you should never go in for large quantity. That large peg should be avoided strictly. It has to be the small peg. Incidentally, you must have heard this term a lot, Patiala peg. I can tell you a bit of background of this Patiala peg. One British team, one English team was in Patiala to play cricket. And this was better than the Patiala team. And the then Maharaja was very keen that his team should win. So he subtly told his assistants to get them drunk, to get the English cricketers drunk the previous night. So what they did was they poured double the drinks. When it went to them, and obviously they felt it was too strong for them, they said, "What is this?" They said, "This is called Patiala Peg." This is how the term started. Next day, they actually could not play well and the team lost. But the term had been coined, and since then we think it is a matter of bravery for us. No, please don't go for that. Small drink. The second thing is, it has to be duly diluted. Add sufficient water to that. And third and the most important factor, this one peg should be nursed for at least 75 minutes. Our tragedy is that in 75 minutes, leave alone nursing one drink, we want to finish whole bottle. Unfortunately, drinking, and rather over drinking, has become a macho kind of activity. We think that if we drink more, we are a stronger person. This is exactly upside down. It's totally wrong. In exactly the same way, not putting in enough water is again a matter of pride for some of us. We have to be careful about this. Drinking too much is not a matter of pride. It should be a matter of shame for us. Again, the same mistake is made in the terms of how much water we add to that. Drinking neat is again considered something great that we are doing. No, it is again harming yourself. So make sure that you drink the way it is to be drunk, especially when you take the excuse that I am drinking for social reasons. If you are there for social reason, then nobody is forcing you to drink fast. If you're enjoying the company, you'll be nursing the same drink, you'll be in good senses, you'll be able to have a bit of fun, then it's okay. Take it any faster, then you'll be having all that fun at the cost of your liver and your health. You cannot justify that by any stretch of imagination. In any case, let's face it, this social drinking is a misnomer. You see, even in a social gathering, if you are firm about not drinking, other people understand your rules and principles. In good, being a good host, it is customary to persuade somebody to drink. That's okay, it's their job. They'll not do it only once, they'll do it many times. But you must have noticed that if you resist, even if they criticize you on your face, later they only praise you that somebody is a man of strict rules. If he says no, he means no. 2-3 times once you have said no, they will understand. It is only, they are only fulfilling a duty. They will say that for company's sake, drink. Your answer can be as simple as that. For company's sake, you please don't drink. Then you can control it. So it should not be used as a reason to indulge yourself. But most people drink for a different reason. They think that when they're too weak, when they're too tired, that drink gives them extra energy, a boost of energy. So they'll say that I was so tired when I went to the party, I could barely keep my eyes open, then I had two big ones, and suddenly I danced like Michael Jackson. Some will say that I was so sleepy that I couldn't drive. When I drank, then I was fine. You should understand what is happening there. You see, our body keeps some energy stocks for emergency. Just as in your household, whatever you earn, you keep some part of that for some illness or any kind of emergency. Alcohol being a stimulant, whenever you drink it, it dips into that reserve stock. and gives you that energy. It is at the cost of your own energy. It is like somebody taking the contingency fund and using it on day-to-day activity. Supposing you have kept 1 lakh rupees or whatever amount for your children's education or maybe risk of hospitalization of somebody, you spend it on a party. Party will be very successful. But what will happen is that now you will have nothing to yourself. When you are sick, you will have no stock. So never ever be under any illusion that alcohol provides you any kind of extra boost or something. It comes at your own cost. So if you can avoid it, do it strictly. You should not be ashamed of not drinking. Our problem is that we are shame-faced. We say very apologetically that I don't drink. It should be a matter of pride for you. But if at all you're taking, drink to enjoy. Not drink to ruin yourself. That bit of enjoyment that comes, that also has a little secret. It relaxes your mind temporarily. This so-called relaxation is only temporary. Again, your own stocks are getting depleted. So, never let yourself be fooled by this kind of energy boost or whatever you feel. The same thing happens with drugs also. It will harm you, and not only liver, every body part will be harmed. You can see examples all around. I can tell you about a person I knew. When he got married, he was a very good sportsman and a healthy person. He started social drinking. How would he to know that this will not only affect his own health, also the health of his progenies, his children? The damage, mind you, doesn't remain with you alone. Even your coming generation suffer. When his first son was born, he was very tall, 6 feet plus, athletic like him, and a very good physique. Then he started drinking. This friend of mine started drinking. 2-3 years later, the second son was born, ordinary height, but fairly healthy. Now the alcohol is increasing, and as if that was not enough, he also started smoking. And smoking bidi for that matter. A third daughter is born, very short, very fat and sickly. Drinking is increasing, smoking is increasing. The fourth daughter is born. She started losing her muscular strength at the age of 15-16, and she is bedridden for years now. We cannot blame it either on destiny or some other factors. It was clear-cut case of the father indulging himself. So we have to be very careful on these factors. Also, we should also understand in this matter that some people drink till very late age. This argument is given by many people that so-and-so drank all his life, but he was in good health. We do not know his total life. One reason why he could be healthy was because his genes were very strong. He was damaging his genes all along, so effect would be coming. Secondly, he might be taking some other precautions at the same time. He may be eating very healthy, his exercise may be very good. That factor also saves our life. And third thing is that we do not know the damage being done. You see, if the liver is, we consider that somebody has been harmed by alcohol only if his liver is totally gone. What do we do about supposing the liver is down by 10%? Those 500 functions would be compromised only to the extent of 10% or 20%. If the person is not dead, if he's not in hospital, we think that he can drink and get away with it. Nobody gets away with it. Your efficiency is bound to go down. For that temporary high, you will have to pay a long-term price. It may come to you early in life, it may come to you at a very old age, but you have to pay a price. So my recommendation to you would be, if you can avoid it at any cost. Do not ever fall in this trap, because it is an addiction. We think that I'll take only a little bit. We all begin small. Majority of the people keep on increasing it slowly, because as time proceeds, as you take it, you don't get the same kick out of that. 90% of the people keep on increasing their quantity, and sooner or later it will be catching up with you. Old age is the time when you don't want to fall sick. Just because your parents had good health, you may escape the immediate effects. But look all around, by the time you reach old age, this curse has destroyed many people. We cannot quote one person to say that it doesn't affect. For every one person who drank and was in good health, there are 1,000 people who ruined their life. They ruined their own life, they ruined the life of their progenies, and in any case, they spoiled the life of their whole family. Your reaction can never be normal. With any kind of alcohol, your treatment of other people is going to be erratic. So be very careful. This is not the friend that you think. This is an enemy in disguise. That lightness you feel comes at a very huge price. Avoid it even to the last drop. Thank you very much.